The hour grows late, and the fire dwindles. The stranger at the inn, now fed and warmed with ale, speaks freely to the locals of his journey along the coast, as they draw on their coats and ready themselves to leave for the night. The strangest thing just happened down the road, he tells them. At the crossroads before the village, I was surprised by a big black dog standing there just staring at me. The locals grow quiet until one dares to inquire. The dog, was it black? The stranger nods. A huge black hound with fiery eyes. You've seen it then? He asks them. But they say nothing and hurry away. They know that nothing can be done. The man will be dead by year's end. His demise foreshadowed by his encounter with the deadliest of British legends, the Black Shuck. Greetings from the Witch House. I am your host, Dr. Gallo. Please, take a moment to subscribe. If you'd like to find out what that noise is that you keep hearing when you're almost asleep. Legends of this great black hellhound have been told around the British Isles for centuries. The Black Shuck is but one name of many given to this portentous beast and used mainly around East Anglia. But, across the rest of Britain, you may also know it as the Padfoot, Trash, Snarly Owl, or, simply, Shuck. Descriptions of its appearance may vary from region to region, but chiefly, you would know the Shuck by its sheer size. The beast is massive, easily as big as a calf or horse. Its eyes burn fiery red, although sometimes it appears to have only one, in the center of its forehead, akin to the cyclops. Some iterations claim that its paws turn oddly backward, but all insist that its footfalls are entirely silent, even when it runs at speed. Once seen, the shark foretells death, either for the witness or a close family member, sometimes by the end of the year, and sometimes within mere weeks. There are many recorded sightings of the Black Shuck throughout history. In his 1901 book, Highways and Byways of East Anglia, W. A. Dutt describes the creature as follows.
He takes the form of a huge black dog and prowls along the dark lanes and lonesome field footpaths where, although his howling makes the hearer's blood run cold, his footfalls make no sound. You may know him at once, should you see him, by his fiery eye. He has but one, and that, like the cyclops, is in the middle of its head. But such an encounter might bring you the worst of luck. It is even said that to meet him is to be warned that your death will occur before the end of the year, so you will do well to shut your eyes if you hear him howling. Shut them, even if you are uncertain whether it is the dog fiend or the voice of the wind you hear.
Earlier still, on the 4th of August 1577, the beast is said to have claimed two lives. It burst through the doors of Holy Trinity Church at Blythburgh with a clap of thunder and snapped the necks of two parishioners before causing the church's steeple to collapse into the roof. It was claimed here that the shuck was the devil in the likeness of a dog, and as it left the church, left scorch marks at the door, which can be seen to this day and are referred to locally as the devil's fingerprints. Tales of the shuck persist even in recent history. There was an anecdote in an old Essex newspaper in the 1930s about a midwife who was stalked by the beast on a winter's night. As she cycled home throughout the country lanes, a huge black dog appeared from nowhere and ran alongside her bike for several miles, no matter how hard she pedaled to escape. Mercifully, it vanished without further incident. The Black Shuck has been immortalized in popular culture many times. In the 2019 film, Annabelle Comes Home, the Black Shuck is one of many evil spirits unleashed by the doll. It is a mini-boss in Assassin's Creed Valhalla, and can be found devouring a corpse in a ruined building as the player explores East Anglia. If you're a little longer in the tooth, you might have come across the Black Shuck in Usborne's legendary 1977 book, World of the Unknown, Ghosts. Nightmare fuel for many a schoolchild. With a bit of luck, I'll make it into volume 2. So take care on your travels, especially at night, and especially along the lonely roads and highways. That strange dog you can hear howling in the distance might be on the lookout for a new bone to chew on, and you've got about 200 of them.